Today we're going to look at the shatter effect in Canva. So here we are in Canva with the finished image, and it's actually pretty simple to do, but there are a couple things I want to point out to you. So I'm going to show you how to do this from scratch. So obviously you need an image that you'd like to use, and I already selected this image to use. So one thing you have to realize with certain images in Canva in relation to stock photos, and this might apply to your own images as well. If I click on the image itself and go to the background color, it's gonna reveal the main photo colors of the image. Now keep that in mind. But if I use this image, for example, I'm gonna bring that down a bit. If I click on the colors again, it doesn't show the photo colors. Now, one of the ways around that is to go to Canva's color palette generator. If you just Google that, or I'll leave the link in the description below. You can upload an image, which I've already done, and it's going to generate the main colors for you. So what I could do here now is that if you go into add another palette, you can bring these brand colors in, which I've already done, and use those brand colors instead. So now that I've added these colors, you see it on my portfolio colors here so that I can, you know, match the colors. So that's a quick little tip for you. So back to this main image here. Now, one of the strategies here actually is to remove the background so that you're working with fewer colors. So head on over to effects on the top left here, and we want to remove the background. Now that we have a clean image, the next thing you want to do is go into elements and type in splatter. I know this is called the shatter effect, but the element we're using is splatter. What I like to do is pick two types of splatter designs. So the first one's gonna be this one. And for the second one, I'm just gonna steal from up here so that it's consistent. So the way this works is that you want to get your splatter element to match the color that you have on the material. So if I just kind of hover over here, you see that this area matches this color. I'm gonna shrink this down a bit, rotate it so it looks like it's coming out of the material. There you go. And then I'm gonna add this on top, but I'm going to now pick either the same color or maybe just a bit darker. Let's see how it looks, just to kind of give it a little effect. And you wanna make sure that it blends in there, okay? So then I'm gonna repeat the same thing for this down here, but you'll notice that the color is much darker. So I'm gonna change this color now to the darker tone here. Probably the darker one, there you go. So that matches. So as you can see, you know, it's starting to take shape, but that's pretty much the strategy behind this, is to make the colors blend and do a whole bunch of them. So I'm just gonna group these together and copy and paste them, but I'm gonna change the size and have it come out that way. Now I'm gonna change these to white, so it has that torn look, right? And yeah, that's pretty much it. I would just repeat this strategy. I'll make multiple copies of these. Just copy and paste them. Make sure the colors are matching though to the color. So for example, if I put that there, now I'm gonna change this color to match the darker tone a little bit. So then you get that type of effect. Now I want that to be a little bit bigger. And then again for here, you see that this tone is more of like a pink. So I'm gonna take these, copy and paste them over. place it over here, but now I'll make it a little bigger, color these to the lighter tone there so that matches. And again, the trick here is to have a clear background. That's what the white color does. It gives it that illusion that there's tears and all these splatters that's, you know, affecting the material. Anyway, you get the point. So you see, you could really go crazy with this. And of course, with the text, basically I just put in text. And I used neon, brought it all the way up. And what I had done was just copied some of these and brought some over, you know, wherever they made sense. Yeah, just put it over the text and, you know, make it look like it's going over the text to give it a bit of depth. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Now, if you like this effect, make sure to leave a comment below and hit that thumbs up button. It really helps the channel. And if you've ever wondered how to create that outline around your image, make sure to check out this video coming up.